Hello again, everyone. It's Ken LaRue from the Shotgun Team, and here's our tip for the day in our 30 tips in 30 days. And this has to do with the task page and what is called the Gantt Overlays. We already know that the task page is an extremely powerful tool for controlling or scheduling who's working on what task. And there's so much information on this page that allows you to keep track of everything that is going on in your production. On each one of these shots, we can see we've got a bunch of different tasks. We've got artists that are working on it. In our Gantt display, I can come in and easily change and manipulate the timing, the start date, the due date, and so on. But there are also some other very powerful apps for crew planning and project timeline and so on. And if we go to our apps flyout up here on the top of our global navigation bar, we can see crew planning and project timeline. Those are the two apps I was just referring to. So if I go and view crew planning, it's going to open up. On the left-hand side, we see a list of all the crew, all the artists that are available to us. And we can see over here all the different projects they are scheduled to be working on. And a key part also is you'll see the indication of who is on vacation and when. This would be really great if I could see this on our task page. That's what the Gantt overlays are. So let's go back over to our task page, and you'll see right up here, there's this button that reads Gantt Display. If I expand that, you'll see several different options we have to display more information in the Gantt display. So I want to choose bookings and vacations. Now you'll see the overlay takes place where the vacations are indicated in these gray areas. I'm looking at this and I see that I've got Matthew scheduled to be doing the rigging the same time he's on vacation. So what do I need to do? I need to assign that task to someone who's not on vacation. So now I can easily come in here and edit this and say, okay, well, let's take Matthew off of that task. I know Gary is free at that time, so let's add Gary. And now I no longer have a conflict of Matthew being on vacation when I needed the rigging done. Now you'll also notice that I've got this gray highlighted area. If I bring my cursor over it, it's indicating that Will is not scheduled to be working on this project until December 23rd. But we can see that I have him starting on the 19th. So once again, I can easily change the start date for the surface task to start after the date that Will is going to start working on this project. So that's using the booking and vacations overlay. Now, another app, as I mentioned, is the project timeline. So let's go to the project timeline. And in here, you can create the different phases of the project plus different milestones. When does the artwork start? When does the modeling start? When does the rigging end? When does the surface start? And we have these milestones, such as this one right here. If I hover over it, it's telling me that we have the client coming in to review the artwork for this project on 12/23. Again, I want to see this information in the task page. So if we go back to our task page, again from our Gantt display, I've choose phases and milestones. Now you'll see the different color lines displayed indicating the different phases and milestones from the timeline app. If I bring my cursor over this red line right here, it's indicating, just as we saw in the project timeline, the client is coming in on the 23rd. I can then come in here and make any adjustments I need to the scheduling to make sure it is completed before that client comes in. So the task page as it is a very powerful tool, but being able to have these overlays of more information from the different apps such as crew planning and project timeline become extremely helpful for scheduling and avoiding any conflicts. And if we go back to our Gantt display flyout, you can also choose the group bars, which are the bars that go along the top of each one of the different shots. I'm gonna go back to my Gantt display and I'm gonna re-enable my group bars. And now once again, we can see the gray bars that are above each one of these assets. And these group bars are fantastic, especially when you need to make an adjustment to the scheduling of a group of tasks. So for example, let's say the sequence that the Ellis asset is in is getting delayed due to changes in the film by the client. Well, I can use the group bar to just quickly reschedule all associated tasks by simply clicking and dragging on them. And then also from the Gantt display options, you can choose to hide all and you can choose to show all. So that's our tip for today in 30 tips in 30 days.